Good morning to all of you. Our today's chairman, Professor G. Ram sir, has already joined. And Speaker Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary has also joined. So at present we have 36 participants joined. So should we start now? I request all of you to please mute your mic and video. Only panelist video will be open. Other may close their video. So our chairman sir is available with us. So with permission from the chairman sir, we want to start the session. Professor G. Ram sir, can you hear me? Professor Ram sir. I'm not getting his voice. Okay.
Hello.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning.
Okay. Sir, should we start?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. So we request all of you to please mute your mic and camera also. Only panelists will mute their video and camera. Sorry, audio and camera. A very good morning to all of you, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dilip Chandra Nair, the Chief Patron, and respected chairman of today's program, Professor G. Ram, former head, Department of Sociology, Assam University of Silchar. Invited speaker, Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary, professor and head and librarian in charge, Department of Library and Information Science, Mahatma Gandhi Central University, Motihari, Bihar. Dr. M. Madhusudan, Associate Professor and ex-Deputy Deputy Dean, Academic, University of Delhi, Professor S. N. Singh, Professor Head, Department of Library and Information Science, Mizoram University, Aizawl. All the deans of the schools, head of the department, all statutory officers, other officers, staff of Assam University Silchar, my committee member, Dr. Angsuman Sen, Director Computer Center and co-convener of the program, Dr. Mukut Sharma, Associate Professor and Joint Organizing Secretary, Dr. Mrs. Sumna Chakravarti Sharma, Deputy Librarian and Joint Organizing Secretary, Dr. Naveen Chandrade, Assistant Professor and Rapporteur General, all the Assistant Organizing Secretary, Sri Rajesh Rangappal Darthi, Assistant Professor, Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar, Assistant Librarian, Sri Amit Urao, Assistant Librarian, and Sri Kallol Das Talukdar, Information Scientist. From Ravindra Library and Technical Support Team members, Sri Manjeet Singha, Computer Center, and Mr. Tushar Manish Sinha, and Abhishek Sinha, and all the valuable participants, research scholars, and students. I feel great pleasure in welcoming all of you in this 1 week Dr. S. R. Ranganathan online lecture program on research methodology and emerging technologies for managing libraries, online teaching, learning, and research, which is being organized by the Department of Library and Information Science and Ravindra Library from 8th August to 14th August 2020. It is a great moment for all of us that we are organizing this event to celebrate week-long program on the eve of National Librarians Day celebration. This program comprises of various aspects of research methodology and role of emerging technologies in managing libraries, online teaching learning, and research during this pandemic period. On behalf of the Department of Library and Information Science under Swami Vivekananda School of Library Sciences and Ravindra Library and Organizing Committee, and on my personal behalf, I welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dilip Chandranath, Chief Patron of the event, who has been a constant source of inspiration for all of us. He has motivated and encouraged all of us to organize online webinar during this lockdown period. Many departments have taken initiative, and from department and Ravindra Library decided to organize this week-long lecture program. I also welcome our chairman of the session, Professor G. Ram Sir, Department of Sociology, for accepting our request to grace the occasion as the chairman of the session on the day 4 lecture program. I also welcome Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary, speaker of today's program, Dr. M. Madhusudan, Associate Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Delhi, Professor S.N. Singh, from S.N. Singh, Professor and Head, Department of Library and Information Science, who have kind enough to accept our invitation to deliver invited lecture in this event. Finally, I welcome all the deans of school, HODs, all officers, all committee members, staff, research scholars, students, ladies and gentlemen who are connected with us through YouTube channel, and our most valuable participants in this 1 week long online lecture program. So we have already know the format of the program. So now I will request Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar to introduce the chairman and speaker of the program. Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar, please.
Good morning. Am I audible to you?
Yes.
Thank you. This is the week related to the Librarians Day everybody is organizing. So this year, Department of Library Science and Central Library, this is Ravindra Library, we are jointly organizing this week-long program. This is always a privilege for me to introduce the speakers for this program. I don't think the speakers do need any introduction, but as a part of the protocol, I have to introduce them. So today's chairman of the session is
Apurva. You may open your video.
Sir, there is some technical issues going on in the library, so I'm not
okay.
Let me try. The network is giving some issue.
All panelists may open their video.
So,
yes, you may start.
At the very beginning, I would like to introduce Professor G. Ram. He is the chairman of today's session. Professor G. Ram is a professor of Department of Sociology, School of Social Science at Assam University. And currently, he is the director of Center of Studies of Human Development, Assam University. He has a very long 37 years of teaching experience. And he started his career in Rajasthan, and then in his served there in 16 years, then in Assam University, yes, a long 21 years. He was the HOD for 2 terms in the department, chairman, member of the various committees, member of EC, Code, Academic Council, member of school board, BPGS, BUCS, and several other committees. He also offered consultancy service for rendered for external agencies, like in 2006 and 2008. He was member of the environmental monitoring team of the Premier Oil Limited, a multinational British company exploring oil and natural gas in northeastern region. He was a leader of the team monitoring socio-economic environment of the Premier Oil Limited. He has a very good number of publications against his name. He has published 4 books, 32 chapter in books, 7 published paper in seminar proceeding, and 31 in reputed journals. So, as part of research guidance, he has postdoctoral research guidance 3, DLT research guidance 1, PhD research guidance 8, MPhil research guidance, 20. So I welcome you, sir, on today's program as a chairman of the session. Our next invited speaker is Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary. I welcome Professor Chaudhary to today's program. I, on behalf of the organizing committee, would like to introduce him to my participants and other speakers. Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary is professor and head in university library and in charge in the Mahatma Gandhi Central University, Motihari. He has received PhD degree as a specialist in and master of library and science. He has more than 13 years of postgraduate teaching and 12 years of research experience. He has contributed 3 PhD awards, 13 MPhil awards, 63 master dissertation. He has performed external examination in more than 12 central and state universities. He has performed more than welcome you, sir, on today's program. Our next speaker will be Dr. M. Madhusudan. Dr. M. Madhusudan has been teaching library and information science in last 21 years. He has worked as a deputy dean academics in the University of Delhi and also in charge university library and HOD DLIS Goa University. Dr. Madhusudan is a recipient of Award of Excellence in 2019, Award of Excellence in Research in 2017, PV Varkshe Award in 2013, attained the status of IAO Certified Faculty Member US in 2014. He is a member of Board of Postgraduate Studies in Assam University, Tripura University and Jamia Millia. Under his supervision, 7 PhD, 23 MPhil and 130 project reports has been awarded. He has published 4 books, 80 plus articles in international and national journals and 36 chapters in books. He is a member of ILA, IJLS and other organizations. His areas of interest include design evaluation of website functions, web opaque ICT in libraries, mobile based library service, influent literacy and research logic. I welcome you, sir, for today's program. And our last speaker will be Professor S.N. Singh. Professor S.N. Singh, in full, Professor Shyam Naram Singh, he is currently a professor, head of the Department of Library Information, Mizoram University, Aizawl. He has a wide experience of library administration and LIS teaching in more than 25 years. He has guided scores of PhD and MP scholars and also supervised more than 100 dissertations. He has been associated with many central and state universities and board of studies, member, examination, thesis evaluator. He has many research papers in international journals and public conference published proceedings and edited books. His area of interest, metric studies, user studies, knowledge organization, library automation, networking, internet and social media use, etc. So I welcome to today's program. This is all about the speakers and invited speakers of today's program. I am privileged to introduce the prominent speakers and library science professionals of the country, and along with the professor of sociology from my organization. So now it's over to Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar, for introducing all the speakers and chairman. Now I would like to request Professor G. Ram sir to take over the session and moderate the session and invite the speaker one by one to present their presentation. Over to Professor G. Ram sir.
Thank you, Professor Sinha. And thanks to Professor to Mr. Apurva Jyoti for producing speakers this platform. At the beginning, I congratulate Professor Sinha for organizing such a nice online program and inviting so many eminent and learned speakers in this event.
Sir, and, you may on your camera, sir. Video on.
There is some problem, sir. Network problem and
okay, electricity sir. Continue. Problem. Please continue.
Yeah. So really this program is very, very useful and liked by participants today. So lot of speakers are present and they will speak on different topics of the theme of this event. But I must give a brief introduction to types of research here to start this session. So I am coming to this point. You see, by nature of disciplines, we
excuse me, sir. 1 minute,
yeah.
Sir.
Yeah.
1 minute. I request yeah. all the participants, please off your video because there will be problem, network problem. That is why we are not allowing others to on their video, only panelists. And also mute your audio. Now, Professor sir, Ram sir, you can start.
Okay. See, by nature of disciplines, we divide them in two categories. There are scientific disciplines and normative disciplines. Most of the humanities fall in normative disciplines and other disciplines in scientific disciplines. And researches are also divided into these two broad domains of knowledge. That is scientific researches and normative researches. In scientific researches, we proceed with evidence and then we conclude, come to the conclusion or findings. But in normative researches, generally a researcher begins with some conclusion and then collects evidence to support that conclusion. So this is how these two domains of research are different and their results are always different and validity of those results is also quite different. Now, our concern is with scientific research here. And scientific researches are further divided into some divisions. Broadly, there are two divisions. One is basic or pure research, and the other is applied research. Basic or pure researches generally seek knowledge for the sake of knowledge. Means researcher has a quest for knowledge. And in this concern, researcher will attempt to find answer to some question or test a hypothesis and develop a theory. Generally, this kind of purpose of research leads to pure or basic research. And result is the outcome of that research is theoretical knowledge, pure knowledge. So this research is also called theoretical research. And generally in such researches, experiments are conducted. And mostly in natural science domains, these researches are conducted. So here, these researches are also sometimes labeled as experimental researches. So these are different nomenclatures used for this category of research. Applied research. Applied research is conducted to solve some problem. Some problem which society, group, or some organization or individuals face. And a purpose is to cope up with that problem, to find a solution of that problem. And so this research is always oriented to solutions. You see, social domains, and there are conducted and applied research. Generally, these are action researches. Some action is ongoing behavior is also examined, or some action has taken place, and experience of actors is examined. So such is also called action research also. Such actions or behavior patterns are, so evaluation of action programs and schemes or development action is qualitative research also. So these are major categories of researches. And when these categories are applied, we have three broad categories of research. One is called explorative research, explorative or formulative research, and second one is descriptive research, and third is explanatory or experiment. Researches are largely used social sciences, generally in market research, business research, or some researches also, or in, you see, researches related to elections, or to some you see trend of the these exploratory researches are organized. Purpose of organizing this exploratory research is to get clarity research problem, or sometimes about hypothesis also. Sometimes researcher may be clear about problem or hypothesis, but research techniques are not clear, or framework is not emerging properly, then also explores area of research and conducts this exploratory research. So proper problem is formulated, or hypothesis is formulated, or sometimes research techniques and frameworks are identified by using this kind of research. Of tent, but many some in-depth understanding is required, and then desk research is conducted. Desk actually is systematic account of happenings or experiences of the events which have happened, and it tries to analyze sequences of happenings in that particular event, and that event or occurrence or happening is analyzed and interpreted. So this is one another type of research generally found in behavioral sciences. Generally in such research, because it's a systematic account or description is given, so generally questions asked begin with what, who, when, how, like this. These questions lead the researcher to depth of the phenomenon under study. Then third one is explanatory research. In explanatory research, generally research problem starts with why. Question will be why. Why is there migration towards rural areas during COVID crisis? Why crime rate is high in certain areas? Like this, these questions start with why, and here explanation is sought. And to explain those situations or such phenomena, relationship between two phenomena has to be understood. Maybe between crime and family, maybe between poverty and relationship between poverty and illiteracy. Such correlationship is examined between variables or phenomena, and this is explanatory research. Generally in behavioral sciences, exploratory and descriptive researches are conducted, but in some behavioral sciences, social sciences like psychology and management, and you see some areas this explanatory research is also done. So these are major areas. Besides this, there are different methods used here. Quantitative research is, means when you see research is using measurements and statistics to analyze data, and those data are quantitative data, measurable data, then it becomes quantitative research. And that is also a name for basic pure research, or you can say theoretical research generally. And qualitative research, where only qualities or characteristics are collected, and those are generally not measurable, but some patterns are drawn. Those patterns means these characteristics are related to each other, and some trends are brought out. So such researches are called qualitative researches. These are found in generally in related to social behavior or in behavioral and social sciences. Then there are researches in terms of time also. There are longitudinal and comparative researches. Generally, in social researches, a comparative research is conducted, because social sciences and behavioral sciences generally lack these experimentations. And so indirect experimentation is conducted through comparisons. A same phenomenon is studied in two situations, in two groups or two time periods. Then it is, you see, indirect experiment. So comparative method is very important, and comparative research is very, very important type, particularly in behavioral sciences. But you see, the social behavior and these phenomena generally, you see, occur over a period of time. And also these are dynamic and they change over period of time. So these are examined over a period. So longitudinal studies are also conducted in social sciences and behavioral sciences. That is also one important type of research. So these are, you see, major types which are generally conducted, or these design of researches are used by researchers in different disciplines which deal with social and behavioral sciences. So with this, I conclude here, and I wish grand success of this session. And here I I'm sure that we have very, very good, eminent and learned speakers today. So our participants will be really get benefits, use benefits, and get, you see, new knowledge in their respective areas. With that, I hand over back to Professor Sina.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving an overview of different type of research methods. Sir, I request you to be here and moderate the session, as I am attending HOD's meeting same time. It would be possible for you to stay, sir?
I have to attend another session also, in other webinar. Yes. So
up to 12, can you stay?
Up to 12, yeah.
Okay, sir. Yeah. So, sir, you may now request Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary to start his presentation. Professor Chaudhary, should I upload your PPT?
Yes, sir.
Thank or you sir. Will upload from your side?
I will try. Just move.
Okay. If you fail, then I will upload.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Professor Ram, sir, you may request him to present.
Yeah. So, friends, now first speaker of this session is Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary. As Mr. Apur Jyoti has already introduced Professor Chaudhary, you all know about him, and he is a well-known personality in his area of knowledge. And now I request Professor Chaudhary to deliver his speech here. Professor Chaudhary, please.
Thank you, sir. First, the department is hosting an excellent title on research methodology and emerging technologies in managing libraries, online teaching, learning and research. I would like to thanks to Professor Honorable Vice Chancellor of Assam University, Silchar, and my respected senior colleague, Brother Kumar Sina sir, organizing secretary and convener of this webinar. And I would like to give the thanks to Chairman Professor G. Ram, former head Sociology Department, Assam University, and Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar, Dr. M. Madhusudan from Delhi University, Professor Asan Singh, Mizoram University, and Rajesh Ji, and whole organizing team of this organizing committee, and dear participants. My topic is plagiarism tools and techniques. It is presented, sir. My slide is
yes, my slide is sir. It is coming.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. First, I would like the word plagiarism actually derived from the Latin word plagiarius, which means many people think of plagiarism as copying another's work or borrowing someone else's original ideas. But terms like the copying and borrowing can disguise the seriousness of the offense. Plagiarism is specifically defined as a form of research misconduct, basically. Misconduct means fabrication, falsification, plagiarism, or any other practice that deviates from the practices commonly accepted in the discipline or academic and research communities. According to Merriam-Webster, the plagiarize means to steal and pass off the ideas, words, or to use another productions without crediting the source. To commit literary theft, to present as new and original an idea or product derived from an existing source. In other words, plagiarism is an act of fraud. It involves both stealing someone else's work and bought it afterward. So next question is, why the people plagiarize? So first, people think the lack of time or planning, fear of failure, lack of knowledge to influence others, laziness, competition with colleagues or friends, pressure to publish for the career advancement, lack of referencing skills, English as the international language. So people think about in this. So next topic is my topic of plagiarism. Types of plagiarism. So the types is the basically first direct plagiarism, paraphrasing, rephrasing, summarizing, self plagiarism, mosaic plagiarism, bypassing, non-existing source, editorial plagiarism, and intentional plagiarism. So first we discuss about the direct plagiarism. The whole or a part of the text is copied word for word without citing or pointing out the source. This is one of the most common types of plagiarism. Second one, paraphrasing. It is similar to the direct plagiarism, but in this case, the plagiarizer rearranges the words of the text or sometimes rephrase it, abiding by its content. Next, summarizing. The plagiarizer does not use the whole text, but instead he or she summarizes the content. Next, self-plagiarism. To author use his or her previous work without giving any credit to it. Mosaic plagiarism, the plagiarizer combines different sources and restates it with its own words. Bypassing, instead of citing a single paper, the author uses several references that are used in this paper. Non-existing source, the author cites a source that actually does not exist. The non-existing source is intentionally created and contains no data or previously known a non-existing source has been used. Technical plagiarism. The plagiarizer used unpublished ideas of the another people. Plagiarism, this is one of the most severe forms of plagiarism. When a manuscript is submitted to a scientific journal, anyone from the editorial board who has an access to the paper takes the basic idea and publishes as his or own work. Unintentional plagiarism. In very rare situations, the author could not be aware of already published data. However, checking the available data is the author's own responsibility. How to avoid plagiarism? Take notes and perform your own work. Keep careful track of sources you use. Write tight phrases, sentences, paragraphs, figures, etc., taken directly from the original source. Give credit to the original author. Finally, acknowledge those who contribute your work. So first is two types actually. This is the external plagiarism and intrinsic plagiarism. In external plagiarism, detection method is grammar-based plagiarism detection, semantics-based plagiarism detection, clustering-based plagiarism detection, cross-lingual plagiarism detection, citation-based plagiarism detection, character-based plagiarism detection, and the intrinsic plagiarism detection method. The grammar semantics hybrid plagiarism detection, structure based plagiarism detection, syntax similarity based detection. Now some tools. So this is the two types of tools, basically open source and paid source. So we have as the research scholar or teacher or students, we need the open source. So first is a CopyLex plagiarism checker. It's an advantage for education and business, multiple file formats, languages, variety of tools. Disadvantage is sign up required, free page restrictions. Second one, duplicate checker. It's an advantage, this is open source, free of charge, ease of use. 50 plagiarism scans per day for registered users. And disadvantage is search for day one unregistered user. Third one, plagiarism checker. Its advantage is detailed guidelines. Check if others have plagiarized your online content entirely online. Disadvantage is supports only Google or Yahoo browsers. Paper writer. Its advantage is three tools. First is proofreader, grammar check, vocabulary builder, plagiarism checker. And developed by the
I think net is slow, voice is not coming, sir. Professor Ranjit, can you hear me? There is net issue.
I think voice not coming.
Yeah. Professor Ranjit, yeah, now you can start. Professor Ranjit, you can off your video. Only keep audio on. I think Professor Ranjit, can you hear me? There may be some technical problem. Professor Ranjit will join meeting later. I think he has exit perhaps. So he may join meeting after some time. Let me check from any chat offline. Okay. Sir, in the meantime, we may request Professor Madhusudan to start.
Okay, Professor Ranjit Chaudhary may be trying.
Okay, let him give some time.
Okay. Can you talk to him from mobile?
Yeah, I'm trying.
Yeah, please.
I think there is a network problem, and he has already finished his presentation. Only one slide was left. So he informed me that we may request Professor Madhusudan to start his presentation.
Yeah. So, Professor. M. Madhusudan is invited to.
Yeah, Abhishek, give the permit for my.
Yeah, give his speech here. And Professor Madhusudan will be speaking on referencing in research and web based citation tools. Another very, very relevant topic and related to previous one also. And it's a really a new tool in researches. So we invite Professor Madhusudan to deliver his speech. Professor Madhusudan, please.
Hello, Professor Madhusudan, can you hear me? Hello. Yeah, now he is coming. Okay. So he is trying with another mobile, I think. Abhishek, unmute karo. Sir, you may start, sir.
I think again some problem, Professor Sinha. Can you speak to him over phone? If there is any problem.
Professor Sudhan, you are connected with three devices. Which device we allow you to present? Sir, is there any problem, sir? Your audio, your voice is not coming, sir.
Voice is not coming?
Yeah, now it is coming.
Now it is coming?
Yes.
Now, shall I start, sir?
Yes, yes, please.
Okay.
He is trying to get ready.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. One minute. Just to give me, sir, time. Hey. Is it audible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. I'm connecting the sharing slide, sir. I'll start my lecture.
Sir, you may start.
Yes, sir. Just a minute, sir. Some problem.
We can see your presentation, sir.
Yes, sir. Now,
yes.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Sir, slide show.
Yes, sir. I'll put, sir. Thank you very much, Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha and his team for giving this opportunity. I'm sorry for inconvenience for little this place. Today's my topic is referencing in research and web-based citation tools. Dear friends, you are in the process of writing articles, plotting your books. You are in the final stage of submitting your dissertations and also theses. Referencing is very, very important as far as your research is concerned. It is a very crucial part for successful of any research. Basically, referencing can be defined as a method of acknowledging and recognizing somebody's work, maybe that is used for your personal work or your research work for supporting your ideas. So basically, the referencing is a standardized method of acknowledging all sources of information, data, and ideas one uses in writing. So maybe you are writing an article, you are writing a particular book, or maybe thesis or dissertation. So coming to the purpose of referencing, dear friends, you know very well about this, the purpose of referencing. The reference has become very necessary element of academic writing. So this will give you, it is used basically to locate original source of your work. So if you are providing a particular reference, whatever you have taken, a piece of information in the form of content, in the form of image, in the form of web resource, or in the form of any kind of that one. So this reference basically to help the access the material, understand the material, whatever way you are writing. So that's why the another way, the purpose of referencing is to discourage plagiarism. Dear friends, my predecessor just now, he spoke about much about plagiarism. The basic problem of plagiarism, that is the fundamental problem for plagiarism, is the lack of knowledge in referencing. So that's why the purpose of referencing discourage plagiarism and give credit to the scholars for their efforts in the growth of particular knowledge. So, friends, why we should cite? The question comes in your mind. So, the citations are basically very beneficial to anyone who wants to find out more about your ideas. and how and where these ideas coming from. So it's not necessary we have to provide all our information in our own, but we can take this information from many sources which is relevant to our study. That's why not all sources are good or right thoughts of, maybe some accurate or sometimes engaging than those of your sources. So basically the proper citation will keep you from taking rap for someone else's bad ideas. So the question here it is, we should cite sometimes knowingly or unknowingly, we are taking some piece of information from other work. We are not sure that proper, the content is proper or not proper. So if you are citing that particular source, you are out of that boundary. Whether it is a proper, whether it is not proper, that is not your headache. So that's why that is the original author is responsible. That's why the citing sources shows the amount of research you have done. And citing sources basically strengthen your work by lending outside support to your ideas. So what is the need to cite the sources? So many a times, you know, friends, the citation, I will explain a brief introduction to that also. This is a inline citation, and at the last we can give after the chapter or full citation in the bibliography. So a citation basically is a nothing but a credit or a reference to another document, which documents both influence and authority. So that's why, so in simple words, what the citation does for you. So it will simply says or abreast the users whoever reading your article or your research work. So whenever you borrow some words or ideas, so you have to need to acknowledge their sources. So basically when you are acknowledging the sources, so we have to put in double quotation marks. So starting where you are starting, that the material you are taken from other work, so you have and wherever it ends, you have to close the double quotation. So means here, a simple indication here it is, the double quotation means, so this information you are taken from other source, means this is not yours. It is by, you are acknowledging by way of citation to other one. So that's why this is one. The second problem is paraphrase. Many a times what happens, paraphrase means changing the same words and meaning is same, but the words are changing. So this is nothing but is rewording of something written or spoken by someone else or summaries. So in this case also we have to give, because whether it is you have taken directly or indirectly, so the ideas are from particular original work. So whether it is a direct quotation or maybe paraphrase, so the citation is must. And the another important aspects I want to specify are for your purpose. Whenever you are taking statistics information for your research work, maybe census, maybe literacy, or maybe any kind, but for your research, you are not taking these statistics. You are only taking from the government sources or original sources for particular your purpose. And the another purpose when we have to give citation must means here, if you are using others tables, other works figures, maybe you are taking diagrams of others or sometimes appendices. So in these cases, whether it is a statistics, whether it is a table, whether it is a figure, whether it is a diagram, so this is must. So here it is very important. And this also indicates the work of critical developing your research work, someone else. So sometimes what happens here, some controversial facts, opinions, dates, which might be that is challenged later. So if you are citing, so there will not be any problem at any point of time. So this is the need for that one. So now comes to citation. If you are giving proper citation and giving acknowledgement, so what will happen? The citation allows us to how the scholarship of others contributed to your work. For example, your article, it is in consisting of 5 pages. And how much is your content, how much you are borrowed from other works. So this is a clearly giving how the scholarship of others contributed to your research work. The second one is to distinguish for readers which ideas are your own and which ideas are your borrowed. Means sometimes when you are doing a review of literature, many similar kind of articles, related review of related literature available to your research work. So in that case, so when you are scanning this the related articles to your area or topic, so it is very clear, it is distinguished readers which are your own ideas and which are your borrowed. Means here, so when you are if they see in double quotes, so which is borrowed from others. Without double quotes means it is your own. Third important aspect is it will give the readers a path by which they can trace the intellectual development of the ideas they present. So it is a very clear understanding how this intellectual development concerned to your research work, it is coming together. And finally, dear friends, this is a very, very important to avoid an act of fraud, that is academic fraud, that is plagiarism. Coming to these days, very, you know very well, and now by this time you have good knowledge about plagiarism, as my predecessor already explained in detail, and you have gained much knowledge about plagiarism. Let me brief. I will link with citation and academic honesty. So to maintain the honesty pursuit is very, very important. So that's why it be important to cite the works of others. Otherwise, knowingly presenting the work of others as one's your own is treated as demanding the work of his or own. So that's why, if it is taken, if it is a good, okay. Otherwise, if it is not good, so then it is all credit goes to you. And finally, one fine day, you will find very difficult. Then, it's a failure to give credit to quotes or unique ideas. Definitely result in, it is a very, very other disciplinary actions. And these days, you know, friends, UG is very strict and anti plagiarism regulations already passed and in the implementing in the different universities and with stringent. So to avoid disciplinary actions, always credit should be given to the original author of information. So that is very important. Coming to the referencing and referencing styles. Dear friends, you know very well about this one, the referencing. The referencing basically done in two places, in it is called in text and in the bibliography, or sometimes at the end of the research work. So basically the referencing is done, this is a first need to give a brief reference to the body of the text, that is called in text citation, and secondly a detailed reference provided at the end of the chapter. Sometimes every chapter you are seeing the references, and sometimes we will see at the end of the research work, maybe your MPhil or PhD thesis, MPhil dissertation or PhD thesis, we will see the bibliography, that section. So that where this the full that the bibliographical details about that reference it is given. So usually done in two places, in text and the bibliography. Now there is a question, friends. Sometimes there is a confusion. What is reference? What is bibliography? So references basically are the sources of information or statements. For example, books, journals, articles, websites, which have been used in writing a particular book, manuscript, thesis, dissertation, or any other. But a bibliography is nothing but it is a list, includes all the references, but it may also contain details of other documents you have not consulted, but you have not mentioned directly in your research work also. This means bibliography contains all the references what you have cited throughout your research work, from chapter 1 to chapter last. And it also, in addition to that citations, it also, some of them, the classical works which are not cited directly in your chapter or in your thesis, but this will appear in the bibliography, because these are the classical works which are provided some kind of motivation, some kind of ideas, then made your work. So that's why, in simple, in the reference list, only those sources are included which have been mentioned in text citation. But in bibliography, these are allowed to mention the sources which are used to gather the background information, but are not mentioned in the document as in text citation. It's clear. So now, sometimes you are also seeing in the reference part, reference section, or in the bibliography section, sometimes you are seeing IBID, OPSIT, LOCSIT. What these are? Sometimes you are confusing also. These are, sometimes they are using, and sometimes it is unable to understand. Those are new students and new research scholars students. These are very simple. IBID means here the abbreviation called Latin IBIDIUM. So meaning means this, IBID means the same. So means refers to the same author and source. That is a meaning. So for example, so maybe book, maybe journal, immediately preceding reference means here a particular reference you have taken. The second reference also same, taken from the same source. So that is the case, there is no need to mention two times. So you can put second one is IBID, and the page number may be changes, or paragraph number may be changes. So the second important is OPSIT. The abbreviation of OPSIT is Latin word, this is Opus Citum. This meaning is work cited. So this means the refers to the reference listed earlier by the same author. This means, so it is not coming, suppose if it is a number one, number two is there. So it will not come in number two, it will come somewhere, maybe number 10, maybe number 20 or somewhere. So that's why this is coming not immediately preceding reference. It is coming from some other places. So that is the case you have to mention OPSIT. Then the third one is LOCSIT. So this is again Latin word. This short for loco citato. This meaning is in the place cited. So means here, this is basically the footnote or end note, the term used to repeat the title and page number for a given work and author. So friends, in simple, in nutshell, IBID refers to immediate preceding reference, means here number one, so the number two also IBID. The offset refers to the prior reference by the same author. So that, for example, it is a number one. So the same one, it is coming not immediately number two. It may come number three, or it may come any place or any number. So last one is locksit. It is used the place of EBIT when reference is not only to the work immediately preceding, but also refers to the same page. That is this one meaning. Coming to the styles. So these days there are so many styles, reference styles are existing, and all these styles, all styles are okay, and the difference is if you are using this style particularly, so this style, it is only that is the specifying the order of appearance of the title, author, page number, publication date, in addition to conventions of punctuation mark. Sometimes these referencing styles only, sometimes they use italics, sometimes they are using emphasis, sometimes they are using parentheses, sometimes they are using quotation marks. So according to that particular style which you are using, so that there will be no change of that particular the reference. Only the order it will change, the appearance it will change. It may be sometimes it is coming in the italic or emphasis. So there are two, it can be the system, any type of referencing type can broadly characterize into two types. One is documentary note system, another one is parenthetical system. So now there are so
yes,
many
sir, you are audible.
Yes sir, okay.
You are audible, sir. You can speak.
Okay. So the main important styles are used, widely used in the world are MLA and APA. So APA, the current edition is 6th edition, which was published in 2010. So the citation format basically requires parenthetical. As I mentioned earlier, the parenthetical and the document. So this is APA. Parenthetical citation within the text rather than the end notes or footnotes. So there is no need to give end notes or footnotes. Here, all the citations must be hanging indent format. Means here, suppose the particular reference in 2-3 lines, the second line should start from hanging. So that is according to this one, it will start from 7-8 character. So APA style requires double spacing throughout the references. So these are the, as far as the APA is concerned. So the another important the referencing style is MLA. So MLA stands for Modern Language Association of America. The current edition is 8th edition, which was published in 2016. So this MLA also, it is a parenthetical system of referencing both APA and MLA. So this also, in-text reference also coming contesting, and also it is using this page in the bracket. So both in-text and the end of the bibliography. So now question coming here, though they are using this the problem, the citation tools which are integrated with the databases like the Scopus, Web of Science or LISA, already this made available so intranet environment, because
you want to have more PPT.
Yeah, yes sir.
It is not coming right now.
Right now, 1 minute sir.
Yeah.
Okay, 1 minute sir. It's not coming, sir. You give me from there, sir. You can ask that from there.
PPT is not coming, sir.
My screen, it is coming, sir.
can upload.
1 minute, okay, sir.
I request others not to present. I think, yes, sir, your PPT is not.
Now it's coming. Okay, yes. Sir. Okay, sir. Sorry, sir. Sorry for inconvenience. So, yes. Now, the question comes here. Here it is. The problem here, we are using commercial citation tools. So, these are only, we can use. Within the campus, because these are IP based resources authenticated by the server. So that's why normally we will use these citation tools in our homes or other than that the boundary of our intranet or maybe local area or campus wide area network. So now question is, we want to use anywhere, anytime, any place means here. This only is the pre-web-based citation tools are important. What I want to present with both theoretically and practically today is web-based citation tools. So these are freely available citation tools. If without any knowledge about whether you have any knowledge about MLA, whether you have knowledge about APA or any other referencing knowledge, you don't have no problem. It automatically creates and it will gives you systematically without any problem, because the most of the time these citations comes at the end of your research. By that time the research scholars are in tension and they do not have much time to devote to correct it, and if you open any thesis or any work, so some many problems are you are seeing and pointing in this section. So to avoid this such kind of problems, and the web-based citation tools, as far as the libraries, library bylaws of library science is concerned, strengthening the fourth law of library science, that is the save the time of the reader. So the web-based citation tools are basically two types. One is manual, another one is autocite. And most of the web-based citation tools are both having manual also, autocite also. But when we have to use manual, when we have to use autocite, that I will give you emphasis more. So if a particular source which is not available on internet, so you have to enter manually all the bibliographical fields. I will also give you demonstration of this one without any problem, and you can ask after this my presentation, I will give a live demonstration without any problem. And second one is autocite. So this is a creating online, simply entering title like Google search or OPAC search, automatically it will take that one and it will give you citations. So now there are so many free web-based citation tools are available on internet. So some of them are I am giving. So whenever you are seeing this, please see on this slide, these are freely available web-based citation tools. The first one is here, it is a BibMe. This is the name of the web-based citation tools. So the second line, what you are seeing here, this is it will provide your references according to MLA, according to APA, according to Chicago, according to Turbidgen format. Means here, first and foremost, you have to choose which is your citation referencing style, whether it is MLA, APA. According to that, you have to choose this particular tool. So the URL also mentioned here, this is a bibme.org. The second one is like Bibmatic. It is also having, almost all these web-based citation tools are having MLA, APA is a common one, and the others are changing according to that nature of that one. Sometimes, for example, you can see the second one is Bibmatic. So Bibmatic only autocite, there is no manual. So in the case of Bibme, it is available both manual entry also autocite. So my kind suggestion for you, it is whenever you are choosing a particular web-based citation tools, so it must both having manual entry also autocite. That is advisable, because There are so many available. For example, the another important citation wizard, citation builder, all you can go. You can go only, you have to see second line very importantly, whether it is a manual entry or both. And this also manual entry. Citation wizard also manual entry. Coming to this one, citation mission. So this is also, it is very important. So this is also providing MLA, APA, Chicago out. And both is available, manual also, auto-site also. Easy bit. This also having same one. So both manual and I will give you a demonstration on EasyBib, Bibimi, citation mission later. Harvard generator. So those are, this is Harvard generator only having Harvard format, but it is available both manual also auto sent. But this is a Harvard style is very famous for the business and commerce. So if any particularly they want for particular this purpose, they have some tools like this. These are only some of them and only for your for information, okay? And there are more also, but I'm not showing your all citation web-based speech citation tools, but these are the some of the examples. If you have knowledge about one web-based citation tools, you can easily work on any web-based citation tool without any problem. So now, in addition to this, there are social networking tools also available these days, SiteU like Canutia, Mendeley, ResearchGate. These also having facilitating and providing in the same manner, but not exactly that manner. Okay, so now it's a time for demonstration, because listening theory about what is referencing, how to build. So many a time research scholars finding very difficulty, because of my knowledge, I have a thorough knowledge about this area and also guided many dissertations and also written good papers in this one. So many a times they are very good in the research scholars are very good in their research work, but very poor in citation styles. So they are struggling at this point. So that's why this basically the my intention of this lecture, to remove the tension in construction of building this citations without having proper knowledge how to build that one. So that's why I'm showing here, this is the EasyBib citation tool. All these are free. Only thing is, sometimes you have to when you are opening these tools, the right side of your screen advertisements will come, and sometimes you have to register. That's all. It will not be, there is no need fee. And these are all, these tools are also available both commercial also, free also. Okay, but when you are creating only bibliographic references citations, there is no need to pay anything. So this is the, you are seeing on the screen, this is the home page of Bibimi. So when you are, I will give you a demonstration. When you are opening, all are looking like same. Only slight difference is there. But maybe you are seeing here it is some like very good icons like book, magazine, newspapers. In other form, maybe only text will appear. So, but when you are going for autofill mode or manual mode, okay? So autofill means here, as I mentioned, a particular work, it is already available in e-journal, e-book, or available on internet. There is no, simply just you give some keyword or maybe author name or maybe anything, automatically it will bring, and you can choose this one. There is no need. But if the particular journal, it is not available on internet, so you have to enter manual entry. So this is the entry. Okay, I will show you this one. Coming to this, the another one is citation mission. So the same one, this is also same. It will, first you have to choose your style, followed by this one. So further information, you can go to this. There are good two articles available. One is online citation tools. In this paper, it is given all the tools with comparative study I evaluated with my scholar Misa. Okay, and I also written another article, use of online tools by students and research scholars of Department of Life. This is available freely. Okay, now it's a time for live demonstration. So I will give you how
sir,
you, yes,
thank
I will
you
give
so
you
so much.
Sir, I will give a live demonstration, one or two, that will help you. Okay, so
sir, do you want to have more time?
Yeah. 2 minutes, sir.
Okay.
Permitted?
Yes.
Okay. Just I will give you. See, you are seeing here. This is, we can give. Easy BIP. Okay. Just you can search any of your browser. It will come like this. Okay. So this is a easy BIP free. Okay, so now I will create and I will show you one demonstration, then it is very easy for you. Okay, when it comes like this, you can see what you want. It will create citation, just click on citation. Okay, so then it will ask you which source you want to cite, website, you want to cite a book, you want to cite journal. Okay, for example, I am taking journal. Okay, so just I am giving here because this I am using EasyBib tool. Okay, so the plagiarism tool is not free, only this citation tool is easy. Okay, forget about this right side of your screen, that is advertisements. Okay, now I am giving here web-based library services. Okay, this is the one keywords. Okay, then particular author also you want, you can give like this. Okay, then just simply search. So it will give you a list like this. It will come list like this. Okay, like this it is coming. See here, all the results. It will search also, Jester also, Scopus also, and all webs. And so you have to find out here which article really you are citing. For example, the first one. Okay, simply you click on this one. This will coming in two steps. So all this first step. To second step, it is coming all the details about your journal. This is published in electronic journal 2012 and publication month. I'm given, not given, automatically it is taken, title, everything is taken, continue. Okay, so it will give you, it will take you all this one. Suppose sometimes what happens, sometimes if you want to modify this automated, then there is a possibility here you can modify also. Sometimes surname comes and the forename, maybe some problem or maybe anything you want to do, this stage you can do. This is the auto, what you are seeing on the screen is auto site. Automatically you are taken. See, journal name, volume number, issue number, starting page, end page, and including DOI. So now just you click complete citation. So automatically it will come according to this one. So this will come. Okay. Now it has come like this. So there are so many options here. Suppose like this, now it is according to MLA. You want to change citation style, you can change from here. This is according to MLA 8. You want to make this same one according to MLA 7, according to APA. You can also change from here. Once you create, then you can change. And secondly, the interestingly, what it will do, I will tell you. Suppose you can do whatever you want. Suppose you have 100, you have 200, you have 300. So no problem. You can similarly enter one by one. So this one automatically arranging alphabetical order of the author. So it will build a big list alphabetical order. So only see here it is there alphabetically. Suppose what you have to do here, you can also directly you can export. Export in the world. So directly it will option comes here. So once your all citations are over, it is don't copy, because again this is a very important any standard, whether it is a APA or whether it is a MLA. So the hanging line, this according to MLA, the hanging line should start from fifth character. So whereas in APA seventh character. So now you can take like this MS Word you want or Google Docs you want, you can take like this. Then export. So automatically word file it will create. So it will come word file, then automatically that file you can take and put in your thesis, and only change the title of that This is a work cited in the place of, you can put bibliography and the continuation page number. So automatically it will key without any problem. So this is a one tool. Can I have some time, sir, to share another tool? Can I show, sir?
Yeah, you can take some time.
Okay, sir. I will show you another tool. Similar, this is a copy all means here. Suppose this is the one. I will show you another one. So I will go for this another one. So if you want to put this one, so all citation list it is done. Create new citation. If you want to create another one, so I will go for one book. Okay. So now new citation. Okay. Which one you want? Book. Okay. Okay. That I will go for book. So similar one. So I want to give the year. It is social networking sites. Okay, simply given this one without any author. Okay, so it will give you all the list now, the books. Now books it will come, social networking sites like this. Okay, suppose this is the book, social networking sites, law, policy and practicing changes. This you are taking, simply click this one. Okay, now continue. Now it will take all the details here, whatever related to that one, completion, citation. So this is a, it will comes like this. And it comes to another tool, that is BibMe. Okay, BibMe tool, how it will look like this. Okay, so this is the BibMe tool, the same one. If you are opening here, so it will also show the same one. So just I only want to create citations. This you have to click. Okay, so if you click this one, it will ask you, first you have to choose what you want. In the earlier one I used MLA, now I will use APA here. Okay, first you have to choose style APA. Okay, so now after APA, the first line it will show you the reference styles, and there are so many are there, many. Okay, and now coming to this one, second one is sources. Now again same one, journal, website, book, video, and there are so many, more than 100 sources available. Now let us try for journal. Okay, so same one I will try for journal. Okay, same one you can use like this. Now I will give for it is a use of social networking sites. Okay, so I'm giving here simply here, then enter. It will come same matter, it will come. Now you can see here it is loading. Okay, like it will come here. So if you want also with particular author also, you can go for that particular also. Okay, so like this it will come. See here all it is coming. Okay, like this. And if you, because you are creating, you are already known that particular source, now better to you can go for with same journal. Okay, use of social networking sites, you can go for author name also, like this. Now it will come same manner. Okay, now you can see here it will come here. See, this is the one I am looking for. Okay, so now you can select like this, it will come like this. Final step, because this is the loop. Suppose something if you are wrongly selected, then you can go back also. So then if you click this one, it will take you final step. So it will create all now auto generated. The another important is sometimes if you want to enter manually, means all these same fields it will come, you have to enter. That is called manual. Automatically it is taken. Okay, like this, and create. It will create like same one. Okay, now you can see automatically it is taken. Okay, fourth, and same one, save your work, download to particular word, copy and paste, and you can switch it to other format also, and if it is not there you can delete also. And whenever you are doing this one, so suppose this particular citation is there, how to cite in text, the pedantical, how to this one, you can also use this one. If you click this one, the how to render in the in text it will give you. And if it is a only one tool is there, you can copy and paste. the better idea is don't go for copy. The moment you copy and paste in Word, so the alignment, it left alignment comes here, then it will create big problem. So according to this style, the hanging line must and should be start at the character number 5. So then you can also another one, add one like this, you can go for this one. So similar one. Okay, if I go to that is another tool, I will show you in brief, simply citation mission. So the same one, all tools are similar, slight changes. Okay, you can see here. So interestingly, this one, when you are creating, it will come in text also and final reference also. What you want here? You want to find a book or you want? You want a journal, you want a website. For example, website. Okay. So this is a website I'm doing, aerospace testing facilities in India. Okay. So you can give here, it is search facilities India. So it will come like this automatically. See here, like this it will come. Okay. So now I'm going the website's site. Okay. Automatically it will take. All the details it is taken, title, URL, website, all this one. When it is created, data accessed also. You can see today, accessed on August 11, 2020. Continue. Then it will come like this. Again, if any changes you can make, then no need, then complete. Okay, so it is coming. So like this, it will come. Okay. Now it will come. Okay. Now this has come here. So, you automatically you can export also here, you can save also here, you can copy all also. Oh, these are what you are seeing is a radio button. Suppose in this there are 20 are there, you want only 5, you can also take only 5 by clicking this one. And this is according to APA 6, according to you can go for according to whatever you want. So like this, whenever you are creating all this one, it will comes to you. Is it okay? Now it's you can ask questions. I will clarify your doubts.
Okay, thank you, sir. Have you finished?
Yes, sir.
You completed. Okay. Thank you so much, sir, for nicely taking the theoretical aspect and also demonstration. For referencing in research and web-based citations tool, we have covered different types of tools for web-based citation. So I hope our research scholars, budding allies, professional and students, they will get benefit out of this presentation. And in case there are any question, you may write in chat box. At the end of the session, we will take up all those questions one by one. So if you want to have any question, you can write in the chat box. Thank you so much, sir, for nicely presenting on this topic. And I also request Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary, if you have anything to say, you can tell, sir. Madhusudan, sir, please off your screen.
Okay, sir.
That visual.
Okay, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Professor Ranjit. Ranjit.
Okay,
sir.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you want to show your presentation?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yes, please, you can upload.
Okay.
Can I upload, sir?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Next. Yes. Bus. Second last. Earlier. Yeah. Next. Second last. Yes, penalties. Thank you.
Yeah.
So in UGC regulation, there are three types of penalties. First is level one, similarity is about 10% to 40%. Such students shall not be given any marks if their plagiarism is 10 to 40%. Level two, similarity is above 40 to 60%. Such students shall not be given any mark and or credit for the plagiarized script and shall be asked to submit a revised script after a time period of 1 year, but not exceeding the 18 months. This is the level two. And level three is similarity is about 60%. Such students shall not be given any mark and or credit for the plagiarized scripts and his her registration for that course to be cancelled. So, next please. The plagiarism is widely spreading nowadays because of anti-plagiarism software should be used in order to maintain the academic integrity of the individuals. The academic community should educate themselves about the concept of plagiarism and avoiding the plagiarism. Furthermore, which will help them to enhance the quality and acceptance level of their publications. Thank you. Next. So, copy escape, 100% genuine. Thank you.
Sir, now
over to question. Sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. You say? Stop. Karo. Thank you so much, sir, for nicely presenting your topic on plagiarism tools and technique. You have discussed various aspects, various tools and techniques for detecting plagiarism, and also enhance describe the guidelines given by the University Grants Commission for plagiarism. Thank you so much, sir, for attending this session and presenting your topic. Now I would like to request our last speaker, Professor S.N. Singh, sir, who is a professor and head Department of Library and Information, Mizoram University, Aizawl. So his topic of presentation is survey method of research. Now I will request Professor Singh to proceed. Professor Singh, can you hear me? Yes, sir. If you have presentation, you can upload, sir.
I think this is required.
Okay, sir. You can on your camera, sir.
You can on camera.
Just a minute, sir.
You say?
Sunday. Now it looks okay, sir.
Yes, but camera, your camera is
camera,
not on.
Camera is not on.
Yes, I'm trying to do it. Sir, you are getting it?
Yes, I can see your
yes,
face.
I can see your face, sir. Yes.
Other speakers are equipped to
mute their mic.
Sir?
Other speakers are equipped to mute their mic. Because echo is coming.
So, good afternoon to all of you. As Professor Sinha told us that my topic will be survey method of research. So I would like to, as you know that it is involved in it, will be utilized. Those are survey interviews. Again, by arts discipline and social science discipline, well, to get over the result. So, for arts and social science discipline and subjects, it looks quite easy. Not easy, but you can, another way, can tell it quite comfortable it is. So, first, I would like to define the survey. A survey is a research method used for collecting data from a predefined group of respondents. Simple. And survey is the technique of gathering data by asking questions to people who are thought to be to have desired information. So our duty will be as a respondent to collect the data from the persons who are having the information. When you use the methodology related to survey, it is known as survey methodology. This includes in-depth sampling of individual units from a population and administering data collection techniques on that sample. It includes instruments or processes that ask different questions types to a predefined sample to conduct data collection and increase.
Sir, you want to show your PPT?
No, sir, I will be speaking.
Okay, sir, you can continue.
Okay, sir, you can continue.
You may continue, sir.
You may continue, sir.
Okay, sir, thank you. So, but this is important that how we'll be going in order to have a good design sample, how should we proceed with regard to a survey so we can good design of a survey. We has its beginning when a person faces a need for information and there is no existing data that is sufficient. So it contains following. Number one is they should have no meaning. Research. Number two is the number of questions. We may contain a number of questions in the questionnaire when it is going to the respondents. So the number of questions on what basis it should be defined, how many numbers of questions it must contain. So this must be decided there before you are going to submit it for filling. The number of questions used in a market research study is dependent on the end objective of the research. So the length of the questionnaire has to be dictated only by the core data metrics that have to be collected. Simple language. Another important point in the good data design is simple language, so that every individual through which we are going to collect the data, he must be able to understand the language. One factor that can cause a high survey dropout rate is if the audience finds the language difficult to understand. We have to take care. We'll have to keep in mind that it should be quite and in understanding level of language should be used. Questions type contain what kind of information, what kind of question in the questionnaire. There are understand and answer promoter score questions are multiple choice questions help increase the survey response rate. Consistent scales. If you used rating scale questions, make sure that the scales are consistent throughout the research study. Using scales from -5 to +5 in one question and +3 to +3 in another question may confuse a respondent. So you will have to be careful with regard to questions, what kind of questions you are going to put in questionnaire. Survey logic. Logic is one of the most critical aspects of the survey design. If the logic is not, respondents will not be able to continue further or the design. Logic has to be applied and tested to ensure that on selecting an option on logical question. So once you have decided what design should be there for a survey, then you will be proceeding for the increasingly moved away from the paper surveys to using quick online questionnaires. For survey data collection method has its pros and cons, and the researcher has to, in most cases, use different ways to collect the requisite data from a sample. The survey response rate of each of these methods vary as multiple factors play a data collection process. Another important method that has been evolved now, that is online. If you are going to collect the data, online will be very important data collection method. So you will have to see the several factors associated with the online. Those are what online is, actually how you can define the online. So online surveys have not become the most widely used survey data collection method. There is a wide variety of advanced and straightforward questions types that are available in online surveys. The data collection and data analysis are now structured and easy to manage. The survey response online is very high compared to the other research options. An online survey is a set of structured questions that the respondents completes over the internet, generally through filling out a form. It is more natural way to reach out to the respondent, as it is less time consuming than the traditional way of gathering information through one-to-one interaction and less expensive. The data is collected, stored in a database, which is later evaluated by an expert in the field. So if you are going to opt the online method of data collection, it will be most important and easy for you. Sometimes it is very easy, but in order to understand them, the questions and the purpose, you will have to be in touch with those guys from where you want to have the online data collection. So online survey are having the following advantages. Those may be accuracy, easy and quick to analyze, ease of participation, great branding exercise. Respondents can be honest and flexible at the same time. Survey templates. If in order to see the advantages with regard to accuracy, you will be able to find that in an online research study, the margin of error is low. Either respondents register their responses by easy selection buttons. Traditional method require human interference, and according to a study, human intervention increases the margin of error by 10%. Easy and quick to analyze. Since all the responses are registered online, it is straightforward to analyze the data in real time. It is also ready to draw inferences and share the result. Ease of participation. In view of the age technology oriented universe, most people on this planet have access to the internet. Respondents prefer receiving the survey over the email. Ease of participation dramatically increases as the respondents can choose a suitable time and place according to their convenience to register their responses. Fourth one is great branding exercise. In an online design, organization or business have this opportunity to develop their questionnaire to align with their brand. Using logos and similar brand language gives the companies an advantage as the respondents can connect better with the brand. Survey templates. Leading online research tools have expert designed ready survey templates that make it easier for researchers to choose from and conduct their research study. These templates are weighted questionnaires and are specific to every industry, making the study even more efficient. Telephone. Another
Her voice is not coming.
Respondent and the
Her voice is coming.
So telephone may be the another media. Information is to be sent to the respondents and receive the message. Telephone survey are a cheaper method than the face-to-face surveys. Lazy part and human resources. Face-to-face shows that face-to-face is much easier with regard to contacting and getting the information on the hand. Used methods of survey data collection. The response rate in the survey data collection method is always higher because the respondent trusts the researcher since it is in person. So now I have to come to the survey data analysis. After you have collected the data, then you will go put in the form. We will be so survey data analysis. Excel sheets require the additional workforce to be analyzed data analysis. It becomes much easier and simple when using an online survey platform. Of the commonly used types are cross tabulation, statistical analysis tools that use framework to make sense of data. Raw survey data can be daunting, but structuring that data into a table helps draw parallels between different research. Next, trend analysis. Trend analysis provides the ability to look at survey data over a long period. This method of statistical analysis of survey data helps plot aggregated response data over time. Max diff analysis is a research technique to help understand customer preferences across multiple parameters. For example, products, pricing, features, marketing, etc. become the basis for max diff analysis. Conjoint analysis. Conjoint analysis is an advanced statistical research method that aims to understand the choices a person makes in selecting a product or service. TURF analysis. TURF reach and frequency analysis is a statistical research methodology that assesses total market reach of a product or service or a mix of both. This method is used by a person to understand frequency is there, messaging, reaching the audience, and if that needs tweaking. TURF analysis is widely used to formulate and measure the success of go-to-market strategies. Now, analysis. Gap analysis is a side-by-side matrix question type that production from practical to planned performance. SWOT analysis, SWOT, SWOT analysis, another widely used survey organizes survey data into data that represents strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats of an organization or product or service that provides a holistic picture about competition. This method helps to create effective business strategies. Now the last one and the is text analysis and is an advanced statistical method where intelligent tools make sense of and quantify or fashion qualitative and open-ended data into easily understandable data. This method applied to unstructured data. So that's all, Sina sir. And
okay,
okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
For nicely presenting survey method of research. Sir, please mute your mic.
Yes. I'm getting you, sir.
Equals.
So today we have four speaker. One Professor G. Ram, chairman of the session. He has taken different type of research methods and overview, which was followed by our second speaker, Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary, who has taken plagiarism tools and technique, and third speaker has taken the topic referencing in research and web-based citation tools, and Professor Asan Singh sir has taken survey method of research. Professor Singh has elaborately described various types of survey method, what are its advantages, what are its characteristics, how we can conduct survey. There are various methods he discussed, telephonic survey, traditional method survey, and also give emphasis on online survey. Nowadays, during the pandemic, we also suggested our all scholar and PG student to conduct online survey, because it is not possible for them to visit door to door and collect data. So this online survey become very beneficial for them, and they have designed questionnaire in Google form, and they distributed, and many of them are able to collect their data. So really online survey method is also very good for our scholar and students. Thank you so much, sir. You have elaborately covered this topic. Now I will write, I will request Sri Rajesh Rangappal Darthi to take a question answer session. If any participants have any doubt, any question, they can write in chat box. Sri Rajesh sir will collect from there and he will take up to the speaker. After completion of question answer session, Sri Rajesh sir will offer vote of thanks. Over to Sri Rajesh.
There are no questions. So kindly, I request all the participants. I'll give you 2 minutes of time. If you have anything, you can directly put in the speakers.
Our research scholar may ask some question for online citation. How online citation we can make? Sir has elaborately described. If they have any queries, they can ask. Expert is available with us. Rajesh ji, you may ask some question for your thesis.
Yes, I have one simple question to Dr. Madhusudan sir. Sir, how do you actually compare this web-based citation tools with the desktop or the desktop-based or standalone or installed systems like Jotero or Mendeley? Which one you feel is the better option for the research scholars to use?
It has its own limitations, but these tools are very simple to use and freely available. It is equivalent to use also. And moreover, suppose it has so many options available. Change a style. Suppose you are a particular point of time, you made the citations according to MLA. So you, in some point of time you want to change, it is very difficult. But these tools automatically convert into particular according to your style, even if it is a particular edition of the same style. And moreover, these alphabetically also, partly it will arrange alphabetically. Suppose if you want for other purpose, the same set of bibliographic references, you want the most recent ones, automatically it will come. Least recent ones means old ones, it automatically goes. There are so many options available, like export and save and so forth, and it is right. Because since the Mendeley and all, you have installed, so these kind of tools are plug and play type, and it is a browser based one. It is a much better than the other desktop versions.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Sir, should I move to the other part of the responsibility, that is providing the vote of thanks?
Since we don't have any, I think our speaker have given elaborate explanation of all these. They might have understand. So now, request Sri Rajesh to start vote of thanks.
Thank you, sir. I think we have come to the final session of this fascinating and knowledge acquaintance fourth day of this 1 week Dr. S.R. Ranganathan online lecture series on research methodology and emerging technologies in managing libraries, online teaching, learning and research, jointly organized by DLIS Assam University Silchar and Rabindra Library Assam University Silchar. I have been entrusted with the responsibility of offering this vote of thanks for today's session, and we have number of people to thank today for the grand success of this today's session. First of all, I'd like to thank Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha for providing the welcome address, and then I'd like to thank Dr. Atulpa Jyoti Majumdar for introducing the speakers to all the participants. And I'd like to thank Professor G. Ram, the chairman of the session, and he has delivered a lecture on types of research and overview, which is one of the most simplest for explanation of different types of research which are available. He has spoken on different types of research, particularly the normative and scientific research, basic and applied research within the scientific research. Thank you, sir, for laying the perfect platform for today's session and also for your valuable time and support. The first invited speaker is Professor Ranjit Kumar Chaudhary, Professor and Dean, Professor and Head DLIS MGCU Motihari. He spoke on plagiarism tools and techniques. It is a very helpful topic and nicely presented despite of some connectivity issues we had in between. We all appreciate your efforts to come back and enlighten us later, all the participants, sir. Thank you for your refreshing all the participants on the plagiarism topic and also for your valuable time and support. Thank you, sir. Now it's time to thank our most energetic speaker of the session, Dr. M. Madhusudan, sir, Associate Professor, DLIS Delhi University, Delhi. He spoke on referencing in research and web-based citation tools. He has explained on the meaning, importance, reference styles, and also demonstrated on few of the web-based citation tools like EasyLib, EasyBib, and BibMe. Thank you, sir, for enlightening all the participants with your energetic presentation and for your valuable time and support. Thank you, sir. Now, our vote of thanks goes to the last speaker, third invited speaker, Professor S.N. Singh. He is Professor and Head DLIS Mizoram University, Aizawl. Sir spoke on it is one of the detailed elaborations on survey method of research, including offline, online surveys as data collection tools, data collection methods. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for sharing your expertise with the participants and for all the valuable time and support you have offered to this program. Now it is time to thank all the organizing committee members. I thank Professor Dilip Chandranath, the Honorable Vice Chancellor and Chief Patron of this program. Now the next person is the most well-known person, and because of this person, the program is happening, and he is the most effort-putting guy in this committee, Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha. Head Dean and Acting Librarian of Assam University Silchar, Chairman and Convener of this, and also Organizing Secretary of this program. So the next vote of thanks goes to Dr. Anshuman Singh, Co-Convener and Director of Computer Center, for his support and valuable time in organizing this program. My vote of thanks goes to Joint Organizing Secretaries, Dr. Mukut Sharma, Associate Professor, and Dr. Sumna Chakravarti Sharma, Deputy Librarian of Assam University Silchar, for their valuable support. And Dr. Nabin Chandra Day, Professor and Deputy General of this program, for his all support. I also thank Dr. Apurva, all the Assistant Organizing Secretaries, so Dr. Apurva Jyoti Majumdar, Mr. Amit Uron, Mr. Kalul Das Talukdar, and the two technical staffs who are doing wonderful job, Mr. Manjit Singha and Tushar Manif Sinha, for their support. At last, I congratulate all the participants for acquiring knowledge and refreshing your knowledge or knowledge base and listening to all the experts, Thank you for all, for making this program a grand success. Thank you one and all. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Sri Rajesh, for offering vote of thanks and concluding the session. And now I have one announcement. Tomorrow we will have National Librarian Day. So on this occasion, our speakers are there. But any committee members or participant, if they want to speak something on this occasion, they can send their presentation or consent to me. By evening, so that we can include that in morning program. So initially we will have just a few 10-15 minutes time for celebration, Librarian Day celebration. Then we will move to the regular program.
It's better to start, sir. I have a suggestion to make. It is better to start the program. It is better to start the program at 10 o'clock tomorrow.
Start the program
at 10 o'clock, 1 hour before the scheduled time.
I don't know, because for getting ready time, I will be ready, but for others, it will. That is why I have kept 11 a.m. We shall try to ready by 10:30. If all will be available, then we may start. Because we have already given time 11, that is why. So anyone interested, they can propose and they can send consent to me. And any of you committee member, they can make one presentation on Dr. S.R. Ranganathan. We will start from that with floral tribute. And because we are not at one place, we are at our different location. So through presentation, we can offer a tribute to Dr. S.R. Ranganathan. And this program is also dedicated for that. With this, I request all of you to on your camera so that we can take group photograph. Rajesh, you can take group photograph. If all, please on your camera.
Sure, sir.
All are requested to on your camera. We will take some group photographs.
All the participants.
Participant also, they can on their camera.
Switch on your cameras.
All panelists are also requested to switch on their camera. People are very shy. All are requested to switch. This is time when we can catch the group photograph. You can see in another. All All participants are also requested to on their camera. Please.
I can see only 8 members.
Then this photograph will go in Facebook. So all are requested to on your camera.
Now they will switch on the camera. They should have told them 5 minutes before, sir.
They are not listening, perhaps. So no, whatever cameras are on, I am taking photograph.
No, no, they are listening. Thing is, they have went to straighten their videos and watch their videos and come back refreshed so that
okay, tomorrow all will be in formal dress, okay? Tomorrow all will be in formal dress and we will have group photograph. Today we can take one photograph right now.
I have taken one.
Yes,
in the group I have taken and I have shared it in the group, sir.
Okay, thank you so much to all of you. Tomorrow please come in formal dress so we will take a group photograph. Thank you so much to all the speakers, committee members and participant for their valuable presence and making this program a grand success. So now we will close and move to the next session tomorrow. Please join, try to join at 10:30. We will have some small program on Dr. S. R. Ranganathan Librarian Day. After that we will have regular program.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Now you can leave the meeting.